Now that you know a little bit about ArrayLists, it's time to revisit an old friend, the Person class. I removed some of the methods and added one new one. GetFriend gets the ith friend, but as you can see, it's a pretty ugly method. This is bad code. I wasn't careful when I wrote it, and it's messy. It would work all right if my friends are named Madonna, Sting, and Cher, but most people have spaces in their names. Maybe I could fix this by separating the names with commas or semicolons. I could change the separator here. But that won't really fix the underlying problem. The underlying problem is that reality has structure, and we need to choose the right data types to model that structure. In our case, we have multiple individual people. A string of names isn't the right way to save a bunch of individuals who all play a similar role. An ArrayList would be much better for this. Saving an ArrayList of person objects instead of just a string of friends would allow us to do a lot of cool things. For example, we could add a string nationality to each person, and then you could get a list of all the countries your friends are from. But let's work our way up to problems like that. First, let's store the friends in an ArrayList of strings, without changing the observable behavior. In software engineering, this would be called refactoring. Refactoring is when you reorganize code. The implementation changes. The observable behavior does not change. Often we do this to make it easier to add new features. Now I want you to refactor the Person class. I'll give you some tests so you can make sure nothing breaks in the process. You'll need to update the instance variables. Save the friends' names in an ArrayList of strings. You'll need to update addFriend, getFriend, and getFriends. We'll skip unfriend for the moment, but we'll come back to it later. And I'm going to give you a hint. Do you remember the toString method from lesson 2? ToString returns a representation of the object and works pretty well for ArrayLists of strings. Let me show you what it does. If I create an ArrayList strs and add a couple of strings to it, like this, and then I call the toString method, the toString method returns a string that has the values separated by commas and spaces, and then surrounded by brackets. This is pretty close to what you want for the getFriends method. For the getFriends method, you just want the values separated by commas and spaces. And here's one last hint. If you get an error that Java doesn't know what an ArrayList is, you might need to import it.